Our resources, our heritage. Hello friends, have you recognized me? I am the sun, the powerful source of energy. Do you know what is energy? Let me tell you all. The capacity of doing work is called energy. You all use this energy for various purposes in various forms. For example, to cook, to light up your homes, to travel in different means of transport, for farming, etc. Do you know that for these important day-to-day activities, we need energy? And where does the energy come from? We get energy from natural resources. These natural resources are of two types, renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Renewable resources are those resources which will never get over, like sunlight and wind energy. Non-renewable resources are those resources which are available in limited quantity or take lakhs of years to form, like coal, petrol, kerosene, etc. Through this video, we will understand how we can save non-renewable resources and use them judiciously. And how can we use renewable resources? Let us go and find out from a house in Mathura where a few friends are talking about energy and its sources. In a village in Mathura, a few children are playing in a courtyard. One of them is Ramu, in whose house they are playing, feels hungry. He goes inside to ask his mother for some food.
Mother, I'm very tired. Give me something to eat. My friends are also hungry.
Yes, sure, Ramu. I'll give you something to eat.
What happened, mother? Why are you coughing? I shall get you some water.
It is nothing, Ramu. Just then when I use wood to cook, it emits a black smoke which causes a cough.
Oh, mother, this is dangerous for your health.
It's all right, Ramu. I'm fine. I shall give you something to eat.
Ramu goes outside to play. His grandfather is also sitting there under a tree reading a newspaper.
What happened, Ramu? What are you thinking?
My mother was coughing too much. She was cooking using wood fire. I see her coughing every day.
My mother uses kerosene stove to cook food.
Grandfather was listening to the children talking amongst themselves.
Yes, my mother also uses kerosene stove at times to cook. Dadaji, does everyone use kerosene and wood to cook?
No, Ramu. Everyone uses different sources to cook. In villages, we use wood and kerosene, and in towns, people use LPG, etc.
दादाजी, लकड़ी तो माँ जंगल से लाती है, पर ये मिट्टी का तेल कहाँ से आता है?
There are a lot of natural resources. Natural resources are of two types. These are renewable and non-renewable resources. Let me explain with an example. Like sunlight, wind, these are non-exhaustible resources. Meaning, they will never end. Coal, petrol and kerosene are exhaustible resources which may end and take a million years to form.
Dadaji, kerosene is so sticky. I have seen mother getting it. But from where does it come?
Beta, kerosene, diesel, they come from deep, very deep within the earth.
What, Dadaji? From deep below the earth? Like we pull water out of the wells, do we pull oil from the earth too?
No, children. I'll tell you how. When the dead and decaying matter is deep below the earth, it turns into fossils in a million years. These fossils turn into fossil fuels. And to form the fossil fuel, it takes millions of years.
Is it? Crude oil takes lakhs of years to form? Does that mean that when you were a child, the oil that had begun to form under the earth is still forming?
Now you understand how precious oil is. We should use it judiciously.
Is it? This is a very interesting fact. But Dadaji, how is crude oil taken out?
Children, crude oil is taken out from earth with the help of big machines and then sent to refineries to be cleaned.
Refineries? What are refineries?
All right, wait. I will explain with an example. If water has certain impurities, we can boil it and purify it in the same way to purify crude oil of its impurities. It has to be sent to a refinery.
Is it, Dadaji, a refinery?
After cleaning in the refinery, we get various forms of crude oil like petrol, kerosene, diesel, etc.
Yes, I know, like Mahesh Kaka, our neighbor. He goes to Mathura. There he works in such a refinery.
Yes, Mahesh works in the Mathura oil refinery.
So is crude oil found here, Dadaji, in Mathura?
You know, when I visited the city, once my father showed me big tanks carrying oil in them. And he told me that it is found only in few places, Mathura being one of them.
Look, children, the places in India where oil refineries are situated. Your father told you the correct thing.
So it takes lakhs of years to make crude oil. It is found in a few places, and to clean it, we have to send it to a refinery. But Dadaji, if it finishes, how will we cook?
Yes, the various forms of crude oil like kerosene, diesel are used in homes, fields and factories. What will happen if it finishes?
Children, like I told you that the non-renewable resources take a very long time to form under the earth and is found only at a few places, therefore we must use it judiciously. Yes, children, we must use these non-renewable resources carefully. And man should also use the renewable sources like my energy and wind energy too. Children, isn't it your holiday tomorrow? Let us all go and visit the Taj Mahal. We can visit the Mathura oil refinery also. Go and ask your parents for permission. If they agree, then we can leave early tomorrow morning. All the children are very excited.
Thank you, Dadaji. You have given us very valuable information today on natural resources and its types. I cannot wait for tomorrow to visit the Taj Mahal and the Mathura oil refinery.
Let's go, Rani, and take permission from our parents.
So, children, we hope through this video you have gathered information on renewable and non-renewable sources of energy. If the children's parents give permission, then we shall visit the Mathura oil refinery tomorrow. Till then, let's all save oil.